Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture series of Theory of Automata and Formal Languages. So we are into unit number 4, where we will be discussing about pushdown automata. So basically, in this particular lecture, I will be giving you an introduction to pushdown automata, where we'll be knowing what and all topics we'll be covering in this particular unit. So I have also mentioned over here which lecture number will cover which are the topics. Okay, so totally we'll be learning total 8 topics. Okay, and these 8 topics has been segregated into 7 lectures. Okay, and in those 7 lectures I will also discuss a few numericals, and so that it will be easy for you to understand. And finally, we will be discussing certain questions after finishing all these 7 lectures. Okay, so now what the topics are. Now first, in the first topic, the first lecture, that is your next video, we'll be learning about pushdown automata, its types, that is non-deterministic, then deterministic. Okay, we won't be going into depth of these two topics, but we'll be learning the formal description in this video. Then we'll be learning about the graphical notation, we'll be learning about the language accepted by the NPDA. We will also learn about its moves, we'll learn about the acceptance by NPDA. So these are the basic points that we are going to learn. Okay, now basically I will explain to you in this lecture what is non-deterministic pushdown automata and how to construct a non-deterministic pushdown automata from a particular language. A basic example. Okay, now moving to the second lecture, in second lecture we will it will be a short video where we will just learn about what is deterministic pushdown automata and deterministic context free language, maybe a difference between deterministic pushdown automata and non-deterministic pushdown automata. Okay, in lecture number 3 we will learn about few numericals where we will look into construction of pushdown automata from a context-free language, and we will also deal with mainly focusing on the transition function. Okay, and also the diagram. So diagram is a simple one which we will be learning in the first lecture, and then here in the third lecture we will learn about how to draw a context-free, how to construct a context-free grammar based on a transition function. Okay, from a context-free language. In lecture number 4, this is a topic which covers two important questions. One is a pushdown automata. From a pushdown automata we have to construct a context-free grammar, and from a context-free grammar we have to construct a pushdown automata. Generally these two questions are important. Okay, then lecture number 5 we will deal with a small definition. It will be a short video of defining what is two-stack PDA. Okay, then in lecture number 6 we will learn about pumping lemma for context-free languages. Yes, sometimes this question is also comes, but generally pumping lemma for regular languages is a frequent one which is covered in unit number 2. Okay, now finally in lecture number 7 we will look into certain properties which are known as closure properties and decision properties of context-free languages. Now this is like a little bit of similarities with the regular languages, but yes, we will check it out what new properties are there. So this is the brushing, or you can say a little bit introduction to what and all we are going to cover in unit number 4. And if anyone is feeling like I have skipped some topic or one or two topics, or you want to include those topics in these video lecture series, you can also comment down below. Okay, so let us check it out with the lecture number 1, and where we will learn about how to construct a non-deterministic pushdown automata and its introduction. Okay, thank you.